What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. On today's video, I am going for my first run in the Puma Deviate Nitros. Now this is going to be my first run and first impression video. You'll have to wait till I run at least 100 miles in this shoe to get my full review. Something that's also pretty fun, I have a brand new pair of Swiftwick Aspire socks. And they match. I got these about a week before I got these shoes, and I've been holding on to them because I knew I wanted to run all yellow. You are gonna see me coming from miles away. All right, my friends, I'm excited for this one. Let's go for that run. First run in the Puma Deviate Nitros was a huge success. 8.11 miles or about 13 kilometers, an average pace of 7.25 a mile, which is 4.37 a kilometer. Now, that was just the average. There were some ups and downs. I did knock out 6 1-kilometer repeats. And there was a reason for that, because this shoe is a shoe that is made to go a little faster. It's not a race shoe. Yes, it has a carbon fiber plate, but it's more for those tempo efforts rather than your race day shoe. And I have to say, first run out, my first impressions, it performed pretty well. So just to repeat myself, this is only my first impression video. I will be doing a full review after 100 miles. So don't look too deep into this. I'm always very much in love with a new shoe the first time I take it out. This is no exception. So before I tell you about the shoe and how it felt when I was running, let me give you a quick rundown of the stats of the shoe. Puma says that the Deviate Nitro weighs in at 9.4 ounces, which is 268 grams for a men's size 9. In my men's size 13, US size 12 UK, comes in at 10.9 ounces, which is 308 grams. I've said it about other shoes, it's not a skinny mini. It's not crazy heavy whatsoever, but it isn't as light as some of those racers out there. But it's really not trying to be. There is an engineered mesh upper. It's absolutely lovely. It's very much like the Pegasus Turbo 2 upper. And we all know how popular that shoe was. So I'll get more to how the upper feels in just a sec. But engineered mesh, just like the Peg Turbo 2. It has a very thin tongue and the tongue is gusseted. Now, as well as locking down your midfoot, the gusseted tongue does give a little support to the outside mesh. Because if you put your hand between the gusseted part of the tongue and the outside mesh is extremely thin. In fact, when I put these on, I can see my socks through the mesh upper, it's that thin. The heel counter is kind of semi-rigid, and we're gonna talk more about that in just a second. The heel collar has practically nothing to it. You will see that there are some foam bumpers on the side that just hug the outside of your foot. So it's almost like the shoe is gripping the sides of your foot rather than hugging all the way around the heel. The heel area itself, the very back, has absolutely no padding whatsoever. So it's a little bit different of a grip around your heel. Now, a lot of people have said that they've experienced heel slip when running in this shoe. I haven't experienced that at all on my first run. And I kind of did all speeds on this first run. I warmed up very slowly, and then I picked it up to about a threshold pace for those 1K repeats. No slippage. But saying that, I also don't get any heel slip when I'm wearing the Nike Pegasus, and it seemed like everybody was complaining about heel slip on the Pegasus 37. I actually really enjoyed the way these little bumpers pressed against the side of my foot. The midsole is where it's at. And we have 32 in the heel, 24 in the forefoot, giving it an 8mm drop. Nice. I can work with that. That's pretty much spot on where I like a shoe to be. Puma is using a nitro foam technology, and it's a supercritical foam. And if you've ever wondered what a supercritical foam is, basically they take some foam, they take some nitrogen, they fuse the two together, but they put the liquid nitrogen under pressure and under heat. When it forms into a gas, it goes into the foam, creates little bubbles, and creates a cell structure. That cell structure has excellent properties for expanding or rebounding, which is what makes nitro foams so soft. Now, you've probably run the nitro foam if you've run in a shoe with Brooks DNA Flash or perhaps Skechers Hyperburst. Now, you remember, I did a review of the Skechers Go Run Max Road 4, which had a Hyperburst midsole. Running in that shoe was like wearing slippers. This is very similar. It is very soft. So what Puma has done, they've introduced a carbon fiber plate or a carbon composite plate. It's not all carbon fiber. And that gives a little rigidity. When you put your foot in this shoe, there is no mistaking it is a carbon fiber plate shoe. It has that distinct feeling. There's a TPU plate that slid into the back, also to give this foam some stability. I think without this TPU plate or the carbon fiber plate, I think this shoe would not work for how Puma intended it. We need these structures inside the foam to make it a little less soft. And I tell you what, just my first run, 8 miles, seems like they've hit the nail on the head. It was very soft at slower miles, but then when I picked it up and I really started moving from my midfoot to my forefoot as the speeds got up, I found the shoe to be very responsive and it felt really fun to run in. It wasn't a surprise. I've been excited for this shoe. I've been excited to try it, but I certainly wasn't disappointed. Down to the outsole. We can see here we've got Puma Grip, which is Puma's proprietary rubber. Can't really speak too much about it. The sprinklers were on in the morning, so I did run on some wet roads. I didn't slip over, so I guess that's a success. We can see here the white in the middle, the exposed midsole. And right here in the middle, we've got the carbon fiber composite plate, which Puma calls inner plate. Fun play on words. Okay, so how did this shoe fit? How did it fit my foot? Well, when I first put it on, I walked around the house for a bit. I wanted to get a feel for it before I took him out for the run. I thought I was getting a little pressure on the outside of my little toe. Now that's a pretty common occurrence for me to get that feeling in a lot of shoes. However, as soon as I went running, that feeling went away. It felt good. There did seem to be plenty of room in my toe box. I think when I was just hyper-focused on it when I first put them on, perhaps I was imagining some phantom pains. The laces gave a very comfortable lockdown across my midfoot. No complaints on that. Laces didn't come undone on my first run, which is basically the only thing I want from laces. And I did notice when I was walking, the foam in the heel, because when you're walking heel to toe, was so soft, so soft. I was a little worried about how these shoes would feel when I picked up the pace. But obviously when you pick up the pace and you're running, it's a completely different gait cycle and you move on, that carbon fiber plate kind of picks up and kicks you forward. Felt really good. Honestly, I don't want to gush too much about this shoe because I've done so little in it, but my first opinion of it is pretty good. I am really looking forward to putting in some longer runs in the shoe. Longer, faster runs. But also, I want to see how the shoe holds up to the slower miles. So when I take this out for a recovery run, I want to know that it feels good for those type of miles too. So based on my first run of doing some 1K intervals, I did a couple miles slow to warm up and then to cool down at the end. This, I guess, my first review. Who do I think this shoe is going to be for? And what is it going to be used for? Well, Puma has been pretty clear with what this shoe is and what it's to be used for. It is a max cushion shoe made for running a little faster. So perhaps your intervals, your tempo runs, your long runs where you pick it up to race pace. I'd even go so far to say, based on my very limited experience so far with this shoe, that this would be a great half marathon or marathon shoe. And this is assuming that you're not gonna buy a top of the line $200, $250, $275 shoe. You can always get something that's a little lighter and a little faster if you spend a little more. But this shoe retails at $160 US. And there are a lot of coupons out there from Puma, so you can bring that price down a little bit. Hey, my friends, if you have any experience with Puma running shoes, they've come out with some great reviewed shoes. This is one of them. Go ahead and write in the comments below. If you have run in these shoes already, let me know what you think right in the comments. Stay tuned to the channel because I'll be giving you my full review after I've put this through its paces for at least 100 miles. And as always, guys, if you like running shoe reviews, give this video a thumbs up. I post new running videos at least twice a week. Be kind, be happy, run well. See you in a couple of days.